Well, you know, from a practical matter, the state police gave us a finding of their review of our investigation. And so I could have used a better choice of words, and I called it closed. But the reality is we all know that the coroner's office or the medical examiner has to give the final say-so.
That is Baltimore City Police Commissioner Michael Harrison. Today, 2 years ago, it was about 4:30 in the afternoon, Detective Sean Suter was found shot and wounded in a vacant lot in Harlem Park. He would pass away early the next morning. And there is some question as to where the investigation stands. And the commissioner, C4, on Thursday said it, in fact, is not closed. It is still open. Well, and there is apparently a memo obtained by the Baltimore Sun's Justin Fenton regarding the investigation. What do we make of all this?
What I make of this is it's very unclear to any of us who are watching this tragedy, which, by the way, if you just go back 2 years ago, that 2017 year was so violent. We had so much going on. That death.
342 homicides.
That death stopped. It shook the city. It rocked the city in a way that a lot of other deaths didn't. But fast forwarding it to now, Robert, we're looking at a situation where you have the Baltimore City Police detectives literally going out to the Midwest to interview a potential. We don't know whether it's a suspect
right.
or not. Potential suspect. And the commissioner doesn't know this. The commissioner tells the rest of us that the case is closed, yet some of his own detectives are working with the state's attorney's office. It's that lack of communication or miscommunication that is making most of us feel less confident in what's going on.
So who does the public believe? Who, more importantly, does the Suter family believe?
The Suter family believes the actual police detectives that spoke with a human being
yeah.
and actually took a cell phone and was obtaining DNA from the cell phone. And by the way, the other part of this story that goes into the whole issue of who's doing what to whom. The actual cell phone was, according to Mr. Stefanik, who is the state's attorney,
right.
he said that the phone was removed improperly removed from the evidence room.
By a police officer
who's yeah. now under an internal investigation internally. All of this, Robert, lends people to think that this investigation, whatever it is, should be done outside of Maryland into the death of Sean Suter.
Do you go back to the FBI? Do you try to make that request again, like Kevin Davis did?
Kevin Davis tried, and he still is perplexed as to why the FBI said no. But right now, how can you have faith in what we're hearing back and forth that this will be done appropriately?
And what does this say about the Baltimore City Police Department as there have been 300 murders this year?
If we are not investigating the death of a police officer to the extent that we should, how do we assume then that the other homicides in the city are being investigated properly? I want to remind people, Robert, we are now closing less than 24-25% yeah. of our homicide cases right now. The national average is 60 when it comes to closure on those cases.
The state of emergency special, which C4 and the rest of the talk hosts and Brian Neiman did this morning, is going to be rebroadcast tonight at 8 o'clock on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5. And the C4
Thank
show
you,
will be back Monday, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.